Hello, my name is Catherine Hurley. I'm a developer programs engineer at Google for Compute Engine. In this session, I'm going to show you some tips and tricks for working with Compute Engine's metadata server. But first, what is metadata? Every Compute Engine instance has metadata associated with it. Metadata is essentially a key with an associated value. Instances have a set of default metadata values, custom metadata assigned by the user, and metadata inherited from the containing project. Using metadata, an instance can programmatically get information about itself, such as its zone, machine type, or hostname, information about the owning project, such as the project ID, or custom data provided by you, the developer. For example, if you're working with a Hadoop-like cluster, you can use custom metadata to specify which node is the master and which nodes are the workers. Metadata is divided into default and custom metadata values. Default metadata is defined and set by the metadata server. You cannot change the default metadata values. Examples include the project ID, the instance zone, and the instance host name. On the other hand, custom metadata allows you to define arbitrary string key value pairs for your instance or project. We'll take a look at how to do this later in this video. All metadata is stored on the Compute Engine metadata server. The metadata server is only available from Compute Engine instances. The root URL of the metadata server is http://metadata/compute-metadata/v1-beta1/. Metadata entries are available as subpaths under this root URL. Instances have access to these entries by making an HTTP request to the metadata server. Metadata entries are divided into directories and keys, aka endpoints. Directories contain other metadata entries, while a key maps to a specific value. You can distinguish between the two by the trailing slash in the name, which indicates a directory. Metadata entries provide information about both the project and the instance. All project metadata entries are relative to the path http://metadata/compute-metadata/v1-beta1/project/. Examples include numeric-project-id, which is a key providing the numeric project ID of the project owning the instance, and attributes/, which is a directory containing a list of custom metadata values assigned to the project. To see a full list of project metadata entries, see the documentation here. The metadata server also provides information about the instance. All instance metadata entries are relative to the path http://metadata/compute-metadata/v1-beta1/instance/. Examples include machine-type, which is a key providing the machine type of the instance, zone, which is a key providing the zone of the instance, and attributes/, a directory containing a list of custom metadata values assigned to the instance. To see a full list of instance metadata entries, see the documentation here. Now that you have an understanding of the metadata server, let's take a look at how to use it. Throughout the remainder of this video, I will show you how to retrieve default instance metadata, including the machine type and zone, return all metadata from a directory, set custom metadata using gcutil when creating an instance, use custom metadata in a startup script, and update metadata on a running instance. Let's take a look at how to get default metadata from the metadata server. I'm going to first start up an instance using gcutil. gcutil is a command line tool that allows you to manage your Compute Engine resources. In order to use gcutil, I'll switch to my terminal window. To start up an instance, I run gcutil add instance metadata-demo. I select a zone, machine type, and image. Keep note of the zone and machine type I'm selecting, US Central 1B and N1 Standard 1. At this point, gcutil waits until the instance is up and running. When the instance is running, I can SSH into the instance using gcutil SSH command. Let's get the instance machine type from the metadata server now. I run curl using the root's metadata URL plus the instance directory plus the machine type key to get the value of the machine type. You can see the machine type in the output here. Now let's get the instance zone. You can see the zone in the output here. Let's take a look at how to get all the contents within a metadata directory. We can retrieve all the metadata within a directory by adding the recursive parameter to the end of the directory's URL. For example, let's take a look at the instance metadata by making a curl request to the instance directory with the recursive parameter set to true. This recursive parameter can be added to any directory URL to retrieve all the metadata content within that directory. You can also set your own custom metadata. Custom metadata allows you to define arbitrary key value pairs for your instance or project. Custom metadata can be retrieved similarly to how the default metadata is retrieved by making an HTTP request to the metadata server. As an example, let's say you want to start a Zoop cluster. To specify whether a node is a master or worker, you can create a metadata key named role where the values are either set to master or worker. To do so, I can use the following gcutil command. Notice an important flag here, the metadata flag. This flag allows you to set a custom metadata key value pair. In this case, I'm setting the key role to the value master. I could instead set this key to worker if I was starting a worker node. You can provide the metadata flag as many times as you'd like to set multiple metadata key value pairs. Once the instance has started, I can SSH into the machine. And let's take a look at the custom metadata value of the role key using curl. And you can see the value is master. Now that you know how to set custom metadata, we'll take a look at how you can use this metadata to introduce some logic when the instance starts up to determine how the instance behaves. We can do this using something called a startup script. What is a startup script? A startup script is a bash script that runs when the instance boots or restarts. You specify the startup script for the instance when the instance is created via the API or gcutil. I have a startup script stored locally in a file called startup.sh. Here's what the script looks like. The second line makes an HTTP request to the metadata server to retrieve the value of the role key and assigns it to the variable role. The script then uses a conditional statement to test the value of role. If it's equal to master, then I am the master is printed, and functionality specific to the master node is run. Note, for simplicity, this is not shown. If role is equal to worker, then just a worker is printed and the worker code is run. If role is some other value, an error message is printed. To start an instance with my startup script, I run the gcutil add instance command. Notice the flag metadata from file. This flag allows me to specify the startup script. I set the startup-script metadata key to startup.sh, my local startup script. I could also store my startup script on cloud storage. In this case, I changed the flag to just metadata and used the key startup script URL and specify the URL of the file on cloud storage as the key value. You might be interested to know that the startup script is itself metadata and can be retrieved via the metadata server. Once the instance has started, I SSH into the machine. Let's look at the value of the role key using curl. You can see that the value is master. Now let's check the output from our startup script. To do so, I look at the log file found at var/log/google.log. At the end of the log, you can see that I am the master was printed successfully. I'll skip going through the steps of starting the workers in the interest of time, since they are essentially started in the same manner as the master. Now we'll switch gears and see how to change metadata values on an instance that's already running. As a token example, let's change the value of the role key from master to worker. I can use the gcutil set instance metadata command to update my instance's custom metadata. Here's the syntax for the command. Note the flag fingerprint. This is a hash of the metadata. It must equal the current fingerprint on the instance before the update can occur, as it performs optimistic locking. To get the current fingerprint, I run gcutil get instance. The output displays the current metadata fingerprint. I'll copy this value to use in the set instance metadata command. Now I can run gcutil set instance metadata to update my role value to worker. To confirm that this worked, I used gcutil get instance to retrieve the metadata. You can see here that the role metadata key is now equal to worker. In this video, I showed you just some of the cool things you can do with the metadata server, including how to retrieve default instance metadata, including the machine type and zone, return all metadata from a directory, set custom metadata using gcutil, use custom metadata in a startup script, and update metadata on a running instance. There are many more neat features of the metadata server, including the wait for change metadata URL parameter and custom metadata at the project level. Check out the documentation for more information.